How many formulas do you really need to know if you have Notion? Like one, two, three. That's how many I think you actually need. There's only three formulas that I really use in my productivity system in Notion, so I figured I'm gonna just show you what those are, and that's that. When you are working in a task database, you do not have a this week option for filtering. So if I make a new database, and this isn't just exclusive to tasks, this can be notes, habit tracker, whatever you wanna make in here, anything that has a date property in it. So if we make something with a time or date property in it, and I say make it so it is on Monday. Test this. So since this is being made on a Thursday, if I do something that's like this Saturday, if I filter it time-wise, turn it into an advanced filter, that it is within the past week. But there's two different formulas that you need to know in order to make a this week filter happen. The first is, if we go and make a new one here, is the one I like to call day of the week. Format, date, and then parentheses, and then the property name of your time, and then what you're lastly going to do is put a pair of quotes surrounded of DDDD, then close the parentheses. So this returns the day of the week. And then the next formula you need to know in order to make a this week filter happen is parentheses at the start, then put format date, and then the property of your time in parentheses again. Then you're gonna put the week here, which is the week number that exists in the year. This would just return if I had the formula showcase what week of the year it is. But this is essentially going to do an if-then statement to where I'm formatting the date based on what's now to see whether it is this week or not. So this is basically a Boolean at the current moment. Since the time now is this week, this time property is this week, it's gonna give me a checkbox. Now, if you wanna give it a text response instead, what you're then gonna do is have to put a question mark here and then put something like this week and then a colon for not this week. And anything like that regarding this question mark and on is an if-then statement that really does make your formula usage in Notion much easier. And you're always gonna need to put a parentheses at the beginning of this whole process. So since this one is this week, it's gonna return this week. Now you notice that this test this earlier is not this week. So a way we could filter this now is if we take the this week question mark is this week. So then only things that would show up this week would actually show up in this database. And now I'm gonna duplicate this database to showcase something that is a bit of an issue when it comes to rollups. So if I take this database, make a relation to the other one, and add the relation here, and then take this one and put a tag here. So test tag, what I can do is obviously make a rollup test tag, which would pull in from this test database. So say I have this test this one, if we change this to the tag section, this would get pulled in. Now, why can I not roll up a rollup? Right, so say I try to do this again and I try to do a relation in the inverse for this original test database, add relation, and then do a rollup from that test database. Notice here that the rollup option does not show up. So how can I get that to pull it back through? I'm gonna name this rollup of rollup for the purposes of this. All you gotta do is take a formula and call it formula rollup test tag, and then literally take the property of this. And then what you can do is go back to this and pull the formula rollup test tag. So if I grab the test this, you'll see that this test tag gets pulled through. It's very useful when it comes to numbers, as with in this, we have a myriad of ones where the time total that's pulled in is a lot of different numbers put together. And this is pulling in a bunch of different rollups added up together. So this works really well when it comes to things that include math. And this video will also help you include some tips on how to improve your productivity. That was a poor try.